Hey, what's happening, guys? Mike Mu here. This is a quick little unboxing video of the Lenovo Smart Display with the Google Assistant. Basically, this is everything that you might love or not love about your Google Home device, but with the screen. So it allows you to do a number of other things, obviously visually, that you can't do with a regular smart home speaker only. So this one is the 10-inch version. It retails for $249.99. Keep in mind that this just came out. So if you're watching this a little bit later, you might find that there are discounts available. I want to say that basically a couple months down the line or so, the street price might only be $200. But they do have an 8-inch version, which runs about $50 less. My guess is that might go down to $179 within a month or two, or $159 later on as well. So this is going to be kind of interesting for me because I actually use Google for a lot of my personal life. They know just about everything about me. I use their Gmail accounts. Obviously, I'm on YouTube, and I use their calendar. I even use Google for work for a number of different locations. So, but what is really different about my scenario, maybe this is true of yours, is that I use Amazon for everything else. So I ask, I'm just going to say A for just about everything, or I'm just going to say, I'm going to ask Amazon for just about everything else as far as home control. And I even have one of the Echo Shows. Now, Echo Show is nowhere near as sexy or as sleek looking as this. And this basically is, well, something really updated. I'm really hoping that maybe Amazon comes out with something really nice like this as well sometime in the future, and they probably will. All right. So it's really a nice designed retail type of box, really clean, clear cut. And of course, the 10-inch version only right now comes in bamboo, so that's kind of a preview of what you expect to get. So this is compatible with these things starting out. So you got YouTube, you got Spotify, you of course got Google Photos, you got Chromecast. So what's interesting is you can actually Chromecast directly to the screen too. So if you notice, one important thing that's missing here for a lot of people is Netflix. And we don't know when that's going to be supported or if that's going to be supported, but you can at least cast it to Google Chromecast using another third-party device. It's got Google Duo for, you know, video messaging, video conferencing. It works with Nest and it works as Philips Hue right off the bat. So this does not support as many things as the Amazon Ecosphere at this point in time, and that might be a big reason why I don't actually use my Google devices for this yet. All right, so CPU information. Let's take a closer look at this. Specs-wise, it has a Qualcomm Snapdragon 624 processor, a 10.1-inch display, 1920 by 1200, so it's basically just above full HD. It's got 2 gigabytes of memory. It features 802.11 A, B, G, and AC MIMO plus Bluetooth 4.2. So it's going to have really great connectivity support right here, even though you don't have or you don't see any antennas just kind of exposed. Now, it's important to note. Okay, so it's important to note that this actually does not run full on Android. It runs a simplified version of Android, obviously this designed just particularly for the display. So you're not going to be able to run, at least starting out, unless someone jailbreaks it or hacks it, you're not going to be able to run any full Android operating stuff on here. But that's really not what this is designed for. So with that in mind, the specs on there kind of actually make sense. So this is something that you're going to be able to run for a number of years without feeling really slow and sluggish, unlike some other Android phones that I know of. Okay, so being this is the first of its kind of a new generation of devices, it's actually looks pretty impressive, I must say. Now, I've seen a lot of previews going on with Lenovo Smart Display. I've actually seen a lot of other information about it on the web, and that's why I know about all this. But I actually haven't had a chance to actually physically try one yet in person. So that's going to be an upcoming video that is not this one. So we'll just go ahead and continue with the unboxing. So if you're interested in seeing this, check it out later when I have more of a chance to play with it, maybe a week or two down the line, or I will have a first look and impressions video. All right, so right here off the bat, we see that we have the full-on display, and it is actually bigger and heavier in person than I thought it would be. And look at this asymmetrical type of design. You see that? This is kind of a wedge that allows you to operate it horizontally and also operate it vertically. However, I've already read in some reviews that operating it vertically is really only done for the Google Duo, and it will only operate vertically, not horizontally properly. Otherwise, everything that you see on a screen is going to be, just on its side, and that's not something that you want. This has a nice little plastic protective case on here to keep it nice and clean. So I'm going to go ahead and peel this off real quick. Again, this is the bamboo one, and the bamboo one only comes in the 10 inch right now at launch. It's not clear exactly what the other colors might be in the future, but since this is one of the earlier models anyway, this is what you're going to get. So you either like it or you don't. I personally like it. I think it has a really nice aesthetic to it compared to just plain plastic or ugly black, like the black or just plain white, like the Amazon Alexa devices. Okay, so you got a little bit of a Lenovo icon down here. It's got some rubber padding over here to help it kind of stay off. It's very slight, not slip around on the table or any other surface that you might put this on. So that's really kind of nice. Boy, this would have been really cool in the 90s as a video conferencing type of device. Right now, though, to be honest, it actually feels a little bit bulky. A little bit bulkier, less sleek than I had imagined just looking at the videos. But this does give you a lot of space right here for a nice weighty feel, and also serves as its own built-in stand. And hopefully the speakers are really good as a result of having all this extra space down here. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and set that aside. We're gonna take a look and see what else is in here. We've got a safety warranty and quick start guide. Everything's gonna be obviously configured through a third-party device that allows you to go ahead and connect to it via Wi-Fi in order to transfer all the information. Typical stuff that you would have to do with other smart home devices. So this has a front camera, speaker, volume buttons over on the top. Well, depending on which direction you're looking at right here. So over here, right, we have the volume buttons, power on, off. This looks like it's to configure a sort of hold. It's got a light proximity sensor. It's got a camera privacy shutter button, which is really cool because a lot of places don't, a lot of camera systems actually don't have that. It's got an area to do a service tool. It's got the microphones up there, up top. And it's the, I guess this is the microphone mute switch over there or over here. One of these two. No, actually this is the physical camera switch that actually physically blocks the screen. So you can see right there, see it physically blocks the screen over there, and then this is the microphone type of mute. So if you want a little bit of privacy going on there, it's got multiple microphones up there and up top as well. So that's pretty straightforward, and that's not typically something that I'm going to be switching a lot of, since when I use most of these smart devices, you let your voice do all the talking. It tells you which different ways you can go ahead and configure it. You're going to have to download the Google app and adjust it. Download a Google app in order, Google Home app, which is completely free to go ahead and configure all this stuff. Another important note that even though this is quite a heavy device, there's no built-in battery at all. So this has to remain completely plugged in if you want to use it at all. So that may or may not bug you. That is something that we have typically seen in Amazon's devices, which is probably the best competitor. So it has a number of recommended, if you've never used a Google Assistant before, things that you can say. I'm not really a big fan of having to yell out these two phrases. I'd really prefer yelling to Amazon's devices because it just sounds a lot better. I don't feel so great in saying hey G or okay G basically to activate these things. But I'm really interested in seeing how well this will function. Not so much as a smart home device, but More for a media consumption device is what I'm going to start using this for, first of all. And unfortunately, it doesn't support Netflix, of course, at this point in time, but I'm hoping in the future they will have it. So this has a Lenovo power adapter. It looks like it's a standard type of DC plug. So if you do lose this, there's a good chance that you can go ahead and get a replacement, which is great. It's a little bit hard for me to see exactly what this is. It looks like it's output of 20 volts, 1.5 amps, 20 volts and 1.5 amps. That's not going to be too really difficult to replace if you need it, but chances are you don't want to lose this because, you know, they don't have a lot of Radio Shacks lying around anymore. This is a really, really lightweight type of styrofoam. I actually really like this a lot, and it looks like it's makes good use of maybe 3D cutting to make it really nice and sleek, and also probably really protective. That's not something I usually see in boxes and devices of this kind. So I appreciate that. Now, the rest of the box, interestingly enough, is probably going to be completely empty, because what else could they possibly give you? As you can see, the box is empty down below. There's a lot of wasted space in here, but the box is pretty heavy because the unit itself is pretty heavy. All right, so that is it for this unboxing, and thank you for listening to my blabbering on about the smart display. I will be posting a updated video about after getting a chance to actually use this and sharing with you a lot of nice other shots of using this kind of in the environment, and giving you my first impressions review before I use this for the next, I want to say two, three months before I finally decide whether or not, you know, this is something that's going to either replace or be an addition to my Amazon devices and Echo Show devices, or whether or not you should just, hey, you know, forget spending the $200 here. Just spend it on a tablet and add the Google features on there separately. We'll kind of see how the differences work. I can already imagine my wife using this pretty much in the kitchen. It seems like a great idea to have one of these look up recipes and stuff. I think that's a perfect use case scenario. She also likes to watch videos while she is cooking or prepping meals and stuff like that. So this might spend a good part of the review time there. And if that's the case, I will ask my wife exactly what she thinks about this, so you can get kind of a secondary or third party type of opinion on whether or not this might make a great gift, you know, for your significant other, whether they're male or female. All right. Okay, so that's it for this unboxing. Thank you very much for watching. I will catch you in the next video. Please give me a like and subscribe for more. If you like videos like this, please comment down below. If you dislike it, you know, let me know why so that I can go ahead and improve and hopefully keep you guys as watchers and subscribers. Thanks for watching. I will catch you in the next video.